The Obsidian. I watched your What is Scientology video today. Curiously, I also watched the interview that Oprah had with Tom Cruise. I'm sure you must be sick of him by now, haha. What I picked up is that in the Oprah interview, TC said that he does believe in a God and that he is of the view that parents have to make the choice of whether children should be placed on medicine/drugs or not. This contradicts the view of the intense dislike of psychs, as was clearly visible in his meltdown on the interview with Matt Bauer. Do you think this is an attempt to create better PR, or is TC speaking out of both sides of his mouth, since he is OT7, I believe, or at that time he may have been OT5? As you mentioned in your speech, belief in God is good and well in the lower levels of Scientology, but as one moves up the bridge, it becomes less or frowned upon and not encouraged. If the above assumptions are correct, do you think he would have been disciplined for anti-Scientology views? But then, Scientology does not frown upon people not being totally forthcoming. I would love to hear your views on this. All right, Tom Cruise, psych drugs, and God. Oh boy. So, Tom Cruise really screwed up on Matt Lauer, and it was really acknowledged that he screwed up, to the point that Tom Cruise apologized to Matt Lauer for being so antagonistic and in his face during that interview. It was, and also to Brooke Shields, because he directly insulted her and her unfortunate, you know, situation with mental illness. So that was a recognized screw up. And if Tom Cruise got in trouble for anything, it was being too vociferous about the anti-psych message in a medium and format where it wasn't really called for and wasn't appropriate. So that would have been more of what he was getting in trouble for. And by in trouble, it really, what I mean is somebody sat him down and probably said, hey, Tom, could you, you know, we're going to have to tone this down. There was really bad public backlash on this. Not good. Let's, you know, recalibrate the message a bit. So when he went on to Oprah, which I believe, I'm assuming, is after the Matt Lauer interview, the one you're referring to, his messaging was much more public friendly, okay? And I'm sure he drilled it and practiced it before he did it, because that's the kind of guy he is. So on the message on God, let's be very specific about this. Scientology doesn't have a whole lot to say about God as a spiritual entity or creator of all creation. Scientology doesn't address where Thetans came from. They came from some other place, not this universe, but Hubbard never really does say in any materials I've ever seen where we come from. So he doesn't really preclude the idea of a supreme being or a God. What Hubbard goes on rants about is Jesus Christ and a Christian God. That's what Hubbard says is nonsense. And that's a different idea than a God, right? Capital G, God, or supreme being, or creator of all, right? Or, you know, Thetan of Thetans. Hubbard opened up the door to the possibility that such a thing existed, and he said in the materials of Scientology that it's only when you go all the way through all the dynamics and have achieved a full awareness on all the first seven of the dynamics that you will achieve a true understanding of the eighth dynamic, which is God, or infinity. So, so Hubbard wasn't anti-God so much as he was anti-Christian. He hated the Catholics and the Christians. He hated the control mechanisms of those religions. He while creating a very 1984 authoritarian dictator led, you know, religious group, at the same time he railed against other people who had done that. And I'm not, you know, I'm not saying all Christian groups are authoritarian dictatorships, but some of them are, you know. And if, you know, you're going to have a problem with me saying that, well, I'm just going to point you to the Westboro Baptists, or, you know, Bill Gothard's group, or any number of destructive cults out there that use Christian theology as the fundamental belief system that they operate on. Okay, it's just a fact, guys. So that exists out there, and Hubbard railed against that in order to counterposition the Church of Scientology as not that. That was sort of the way that was communicated to Scientologists. So Scientologists have this view that the Christian Church, and especially like the Catholics, they're the authoritarian ones. They're the ones who are dictating your life to you. They're the ones who are the heavy control guys. And they use lies to manipulate their followers and that sort of thing. So that's the anti-church message within the Church of Scientology. And I'm sure Tom Cruise still believes all of that. Yet he can go on Oprah and he can deliver an acceptable truth that, sure, I believe in a God. I mean, it doesn't harm him or his Scientology beliefs in any way to say that statement. No one's going to give him a hard time about it. No one in Scientology is going to say, dude, really? You believe in God? Scientology is not atheistic. So they're not going to have a problem with that. You can believe whatever you want to believe about God in Scientology. But if you start talking about Jesus and salvation and you know, giving yourself over and you have to go to confession and this kind of thing, then Scientologists are going to have a problem with what you're saying. And it's going to be very hard for you to maintain those beliefs in the face of OT3, where L. Ron Hubbard specifically states that all of religion, the Christian religion, gods, devils, worship, Jesus Christ, all of those trappings of religion are implants from Xenu and other dark forces over all the years. That's what the message from within Scientology is about. So I hope I've clearly differentiated those two things. And that, I think, answers every point on the question. So there you go.